Hello everyone and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube. Welcome back to the Quarter Pounder Connected Career Series here in Madden 13. Yes, he has gone pro. As of the last episode, he made his decision. He's been drafted by the Minnesota Vikings and even had his first exhibition game against the San Francisco 49ers. Well, the exhibition season, the preseason, rolls on here for the Vikings. They get their first home preseason game, so Quarter Pounder gets the first chance to hear the cheers for his name being announced. Look at him hurdle there. He hurdled his man, did not get to the quarterback Fitzpatrick in time there. But it was a pretty athletic play nonetheless. The defense looking pretty sharp. Now the starters are only going to play the first quarter here again. You're going to see Brian Robinson getting in there and getting a sack. So even if Quarter Pounder isn't getting in there directly, he is helping out his defensive front by taking double teams often. And that is freeing up Robinson there for a sack. So third and 11 here, Fitzpatrick getting that out to Fred Jackson. Not nearly enough yardage. Vikings leading 7-0 as the first quarter is almost over. This play is the Bills' best play of the first quarter. Fred Jackson getting loose for a nice run. And that's going to be the end of the run for the starters. So that is all the action Quarter Pounder is going to see at the Metrodome here today. As this sims out, let's see how it ends. Not that it really matters. It's an exhibition game, but the Vikings win 26-23. So that's it for week two of the preseason as everyone heads down the tunnel to the locker room. Coach Frazier there is there to congratulate Quarter Pounder on a decent performance and a victory for the team. So here we go into the practice facility at Eden Prairie. And getting some things done as Quarter Pounder. He gets a sack right there against the practice squad. Fourth and 19 as the quarterback. Look out, he gets pancaked in his own end zone. Forced to throw that ball quickly. And A.J. Jefferson there to pick it off and get the easy pick six. So they'd like to see that replicated in game action, wouldn't they? The Chargers come to the Metrodome for week three of the preseason. And you see Ryan Matthews going nowhere there. Although San Diego is up 7-0 again, Matthews is corralled. That time Jared Allen getting the tackle. Really not much going on Quarter Pounder's way or the Vikings. They drop this one 24-3, and it's just a ho-hum preseason performance as you see Harrison Smith, Robinson, and others kind of dejectedly leaving the field there, but they shouldn't get too down because it's just a preseason game. One more week of preseason, and then we strap it on for real. That's what everybody's looking forward to. So the Vikings will pack up and head down to Houston here after Quarter Pounder gets an upgrade in XP here. He's going to upgrade power moves by 1 point. Hopefully that may help his attributes just a little bit here. So on to Reliant Stadium in Houston, Texas to face those Texans in a meaningless game. But AP is pumped nonetheless because he's close to his hometown here. And he's got some friends and family there. Matt Schaub back to pass here. Is he fearing Quarter Pounder? Well, not in that play, but that's not a real good throw. Knocked down and it'll be fourth down. Houston has to punt. So late in the first quarter, it's a handoff to Arian Foster, and he's going to be tackled as well. Short of first down yardage. That's it for the starters. Really nothing going on once again. Sim this out, and Minnesota gets a win, 31-25 on the road. Yeah, all right. We see T.J. Yates actually ending up that ball game there at quarterback for the Texans. And so I think it's two up and two down on the preseason. And Michael Jenkins gets cut by the Vikings. So you can say goodbye to him. But say hello to the career Quarter Pounder. It's time to crank it up for real. No more preseason. The Jaguars are in the dome for week one. And it is time to get this going. This will be the first one that counts in his career. And he's got to get jazzed for this. So in front of the home crowd, you see Christian Ponder warming up the arm. Meanwhile, back in that locker room, I guarantee you Quarter Pounder is warming up some snacks, getting ready for some fuel for this game. So here we go, getting this one on, and it's time to go. Jaguars with the ball. Gabbert's going to hand off to Maurice Jones-Drew, and they actually get a nice gash there for some good yardage. Third and seven now, and Gabbert to throw. He's going to throw incomplete. No, not very accurate there. Next drive they have, Maurice Jones-Drew is going to get stacked up right there. Kevin Williams makes the tackle. Second and 10 now. And they're doing a good job on Quarter Pounder, but the rest of the defense responding They get out there and make a nice play out on the flat. 3rd and 11. Pounder trying to get away from his man. No go there, but that one is knocked down as well. It'll be another punting situation. What's wrong with the Vikings offense? Probably Christian Ponder, I would guess. It's still a tie game, and there is the moment we're waiting for. Quarter Pounder records his very first career sack. Let's watch the replay again. Okay, so the very first one comes against Blaine Gabbert. He'll remember this one for all his life. Oh my goodness. That's a man that you do not want to run into right there. But yet Blaine Gabbert's thrown to the turf by him. Quarter Pounder is in the record book now in the NFL with his very first sack of the career. Can he make it more as the game goes on? We'll see. 3rd and 14, still no score. And again, they're going to have to punt. Cecil Shorts catches the pass well short of the first down. Next drive, Maurice Jones-Drew going nowhere. Still no score in this game as we're getting closer and closer to halftime. Gabbert's going to throw there. No go. They're going to punt once again. But they get a short field the next time around as the offense is not doing us any favors. Oh, there's a nice play action pass, and Justin Blackman makes a catch. You knew sooner or later that they were going to get going if you give them enough opportunities, but they keep Maurice Jones-Drew from getting in the end zone. It's 3rd and goal now. Let's see what they can do. Gabbert's going to throw for it. He's going to throw incomplete again, so it's 4th down. They've held for a field goal opportunity. Not bad. As a defense, you always want to be doing that instead of giving up touchdowns if you have to give up anything at all. So 13 seconds left in the second quarter. Quarter Pounder's in his face again, and oh, he got rid of it just in time, or it would have been sack number 2. But he does escape. So into the third quarter, Maurice Jones-Drew. Nope. You got Greenway and Brackett and a host of tacklers there to make that play. Here's Maurice Jones-Drew to the outside on the left-hand side. Pretty good yardage. 3rd and 4 now. Hand off to him again, and he is oh so close to a first down. They're going to mark 4th and inches. So they've held another drive to a field goal attempt, and it is good. So 6-0. Now that offense can start any time now. We're into the fourth quarter. We need a score, but yet it hasn't come, and Maurice Jones-Drew is only getting started here as the defense is getting tired. Oh, look at this screenplay. It's going to work. The screen pass works, and yeah, that's not good. Thomas gets upfield. Things are slipping away here. Play action. Oh, he just gets it into his man there. Justin Blackman making a great catch, and all of a sudden it's 1st and goal. This leads to 3rd and goal now. They try the draw play. They're not fooled by that at all. Maurice Jones-Drew is taken down, and yet again they hold to a field goal. I guess it really doesn't matter when your team's not scoring, but I mean, what a great effort by this Vikings defense for how often they were out there. The Vikings finally score, but only leave 32 seconds left, and with 2 timeouts, they're going to take one of them there. You see Quarter Pounder signaling for it, but guess what? They don't have enough to get the ball back. That's the way the game ends, 9-7. A real pathetic offensive display by the Vikings, getting a touchdown late and falling. 9-7 in your home opener? Oh, wow. Ugly. I wouldn't really pin it on the defense. You know, I mean, they played their hearts out there. They did not give up a touchdown of the day, so they kind of feel a little bit cheated by their offense. But what do you do? So Quarter Pounder and crew will have to regroup and get ready, because the next time out, it'll be a trip to Indianapolis to face Andrew Luck and the Colts. So do come back for that one in the next episode of Quarter Pounder's Connected Career with the Minnesota Vikings. We'll see you next time, guys.